सुप्रीम कोर्ट के जरिए ये कमेटी वगैरह ले आए, जिसका हमने कल ही विरोध कर दिया था कि हम ऐसी कमेटी के सामने पेश नहीं होंगे, हमारा आंदोलन एज इट इज सरकार के साथ चलता रहेगा।
सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने भी जो चारों सदस्य कमेटी के बनाए वो तो पहले ही मोदी जी के कानूनों के समर्थक हैं, वो तो इन काले कानूनों के पक्षधर हैं। ऐसी कमेटी के सदस्य क्या न्याय करेंगे?
कानून यथावत रहा तो किसानों की हार है, और सरकार को वापस लेना पड़ा तो दोनों की जीत है, क्योंकि किसानों के मन में ये बात हो जाएगी कि अगर उन्होंने वापस ले लिया सरकार ने कानून, तो एक सहानुभूति हो जाएगी, नहीं हमारी बात मानी।
हम आशा रखते हैं कि दूसरे पक्ष भी सुप्रीम कोर्ट के इस फैसले को सहर्ष स्वीकार करेंगे।
श्री अशोक गुलाठी वो उस कमेटी के चेयरमैन हैं जो कोस्ट ओज प्राइस कमीशन श्री मनमोहन सिंह के नेतृत्व वाली यूपीए 2 के सरकार में तय करती है, इसलिए अपनी ही सरकार के प्रधानमंत्री के सलाहकार और चेयरमैन पर सवाल उठाना ये बड़ा विचित्र बात है।
Hello everyone, you're watching News Epicenter with me, Maria Shakil. 8 rounds of talks between the center and the farmer groups have failed to yield a breakthrough as farmers stick to their demand for a complete repeal of the 3 farm laws. Even with the intervention of the Supreme Court, Kisan leaders have rejected the 4-member mediation panel, accusing the members of being in favor of the reforms and refusing to depose before the committee. Even opposition parties have questioned the impartiality of the panel members. However, back in 2019, BKU National President Bhupinder Singh Mann backed the Congress in the general elections, while another panel member, Ashok Gulati, was the chairman of CACP, which stands for Commission for Agricultural Costs and Prices during the UPA regime. But what is the next step from here, as farmer groups continue to demand repeal, not interested in a middle path with the slogan Bill Wapsi to Ghar Wapsi? The question also emerges over the role of the apex court. Is this mediation push headed for a dead end? The legal basis for the suspension of the farm laws remains unclear. While it is not a court's job to mediate a political dispute, only to determine constitutionality, or should I say unconstitutionality or illegality, it is clear that the top court has set a new precedent for putting on hold laws passed by the parliament without substantive hearings on the legal content. Has the mediation panel then become just another player in the ongoing deadlock, and what is now the next move in this ongoing stalemate that shows no signs of ending? Joining me on the show, Chaudhary Sawit Malik, he is the national president of Kisan Union. Tom Vadakkan is the spokesperson of the BJP. Shama Mohammed is the spokesperson of the Congress Party. मैं आपके साथ शुरू करूंगी। मुझे ये बताइए, क्योंकि आप सावित मलिक जी, किस बेसिस पर ये प्रोटेस्ट खत्म होंगे? अगर सुप्रीम कोर्ट का मेडिएशन पैनल भी आपको एक्सेप्टेबल नहीं है, तो बीच का रास्ता क्या है?
बीच का एक ही रास्ता है, जब तक बिलों की वापसी नहीं होगी, किसानों की वापसी नहीं होगी, वो अपने घर पर, अपने परिवार में, अपने नाते रिश्तेदारों में, अपने गांव में कहकर आए हैं कि जब तक बिलों की वापसी नहीं होगी तब तक घर वापसी नहीं होगी, जब तक एमएसपी की गारंटी नहीं होगी तब तक घर वापसी नहीं होगी। और
पता
बात
है,
रही माननीय सुप्रीम कोर्ट की, हम लोग सम्मान करते हैं
जी।
और जो लोग आज हमको समझा रहे हैं, मैं उनसे जानना चाहता हूं क्या वो सुप्रीम कोर्ट के आदेशों को पालन करते हैं? पिछले 5 साल से आदेश है कि गन्ना किसानों का गन्ना भुगतान 14 दिन के अंदर हो जाना चाहिए, माननीय सुप्रीम कोर्ट का आदेश है, और अगर 14 दिन में गन्ने का भुगतान नहीं होता है तो ब्याज के साथ होना चाहिए, और हमारा कई हजार करोड़ आज सरकार के ऊपर बकाया है गन्ना भुगतान, और वो नहीं हो पा रहा है। दूसरा, मैं आपको एक और बता दूं, हरियाणा में जो बीजेपी का प्रदेश कार्यालय बना हुआ है उस पर सुप्रीम कोर्ट का स्टे है, और 4 मंजिला इमारत बीजेपी ने वहां खड़ी कर दी। माननीय मुख्यमंत्री जी आधारशिला रखते हैं,
सावित मलिक जी,
ये लोग सुप्रीम कोर्ट नहीं मानते हैं,
सवाल तो
किसान
फार्म लॉस
सुप्रीम कोर्ट
पर है
मानता
ना?
है फिर भी उसके ऊपर दबाव डाल रहे हैं।
तो मुझे जानना है कि जब आप सुप्रीम कोर्ट की बात मानते हैं तो जो सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने एक पैनल बनाया है उसके सामने आने में, अपना ग्रीवांस बताने में क्या दिक्कत हो रही है?
मतलब बिल्ली कोई दूध की रखवाली करवा दे तो क्या बचेगा, मलाई बचेगी? जो लोग पहले से इसका समर्थन कर रहे हैं, जो लोग पहले से कह रहे हैं अच्छा है, उनको यही नहीं पता इसमें अच्छाई क्या है बुराई क्या है, तो उन लोगों पर हम अपनी निगरानी कैसे करा लें, आप बताइए।
ओके टॉम, बट आई कैन कम इन ऑन दिस, द पॉइंट बीइंग मेड बाय दिस फार्मर यूनियन मेंबर हियर, द क्वेश्चन इज ऑल्सो अबाउट व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट स्टेप इफ द फार्मर्स से withdraw the laws, that is the only option they have given. You are saying that the Supreme Court verdict and mediation panel should be respected. That is the government stand, that is the BJP stand. The Congress seems to question the nature of this panel, the members and their neutrality. Now what next? It is again the same political blame game that's happening.
Maria, let me put that first on record, that we respect the Supreme Court verdict. The legality, the constitutionality is issues which we are not into a debate right now. The question is, a committee has been formed. The argument of Randeep Singh Surjewala is that these people are biased. Incidentally, your channel itself and various other channels have also spoken about Mr. Bhupinder Singh Mann, who in an audio visual has very
yes, that
clearly
is
indicated
on their official handle. That audio visual is on their official handle.
Absolutely, absolutely. And he said that he is going to support the Congress against the BJP. Hmm. Has his views changed? A. Hmm. Dr. Ashok Gulati.
Yes.
He was member of the CACP chairman. Hmm. A special advisor to Manmohan Singh, has his view, has it been part of the Congress dispensation? And Mr. Mallick sitting here, you please examine his CV, you will find out that he has been on the board of an agricultural commission of the Yogi Ji's government. Hmm. These are the same people who are standing up and making allegations.
Okay, Shama Mohammed, P. Chidambaram says that the constitution of a panel is well-intentioned, but he questioned the nature of the panel, largely raising questions about the members here. What exactly is the reservation?
See, we have exactly said what is the reservation. Like they said, they're all esteemed people. Right, I agree. Now, but if you look at according to the farm bills, now Mr. Vadakkan was going on saying this particular person is said there was a member of some Congress committee before. Now, there are many journalists who support the Congress before. They have changed their mind right now on depending upon it. There are party people. Now, for example, our own Prime Minister, when he was in the Consumer Affairs Group, he wanted MSP to be statutory. But now he doesn't want it to be, isn't it? So, of course, there are these. So what we are saying, according to the farm bills right now, which is out there, Mr. Gulati, Mr. Pramod Joshi, Mr. Anil Gatwan, and Mr. Bhupinder Singh Mann, all the four of them have said that they want these farm bills. They do
based
not
on the
want
merits of these legislation.
So, can I finish, Maria? Let me just finish my point. So we are looking in the context right now. Now, Supreme Court, for example, has done a fantastic job. Wonderful job. They berated the government on what is happening, berated the government on their behavior and said that, you know, we need to do something about it. So they have stayed the laws for the time being. But the same Supreme Court, what they should have done is then when they are forming a committee, because they had a powerful committee of government ministers of Mr. Goel and Mr. Thomas. My question is, when they were forming the committee, they should have asked either the lawyer who represents the Farmers Union, Mr. Dave, or for that matter, the Farmers Union to give two names. And then they asked the government to give two names. That would have been perfect so that, you know, you have a fair and square committee. Okay. If they've gone this far,
the nature of any mediation is about ensuring that both the sides actually talk about the mediators.
Well.
If they have to
they
come
have to be
to a,
represented
yes,
well.
Fine enough. That, the nature of any mediation panel, that is the purpose of a mediation panel. Fine enough, Shama. Let me bring Sanjay Hegde here. Sanjay Hegde is a senior advocate. Mr. Hegde, This is a political dispute. Many experts are of the opinion that the Supreme Court should have left it on the government to negotiate and resolve rather than this interim order.
Well, they are entitled to their opinion, but the Supreme Court had a job and it had the petitions before it. The petitions before it said that, look, there are these protesters. Please, please tell the government to ask them to move. That was one set of petitions. Another set of petitions challenged the validity of the acts. Before getting into the validity of the acts, and all, the Supreme Court said that let's all dial down. Let us try and bring the matter to some kind of status quo ante. So therefore, it said let's order a stay on the implementation of the act. It also requested the protesters to move, and in the meanwhile, appointed a committee. Now, the main thing, bone of contention seems to be this committee, because these names do not appear to have been discussed or do not appear to have been suggested by people on the farmers' side. The senior advocates on the farm on the farmers' side were not instructed on that occasion to appear. It does seem to me that there was a certain amount of gaming going on. There were apprehensions on the farmers' side that this kind of deal would be forced down their throat. Now, a set of people who refuse to have legislation rammed down their throats are hardly likely to accept a committee which is rammed down their throats. So the committee could have been redrawn with consensus. Okay. It can still be redrawn with consensus. That is what I feel. If the farmer organizations were to go back to the court and say, look, this is our problem. This committee, we have our apprehensions. You recast the committee, you either take some people away, add some people, or redo it in this manner. I don't think the court will turn a deaf ear to that.
Okay. Savith Malik, this point being made by senior advocate Sanjay Hegde here.
To stick to maximalist positions is not the way forward. Okay. We need to dial down.
Fine enough. Savith Malik, the point being made by Sanjay Hegde here. If you have reservations with the members of the panel, approach the court again, say that it should be recast, redrawn.
हम लोगों ने बड़े आराम से कह दिया है कि हम माननीय सुप्रीम कोर्ट का सम्मान करते हैं, लेकिन सरकार सम्मान नहीं करती है। मैं सरकार की बता दूं, ये ना किसान की बात मानती है, ना ये सुप्रीम कोर्ट की बात मानती है, ना ये अपने सहयोगी दलों की बात मानती है, ना अपने विधायकों की मानती है, ना अपने सांसदों की मानती है।
आप पॉलिटिकल स्टेटमेंट मत दीजिए, मुझे बस जानना है कि
इस्तीफा देकर चली गई,
ग्रीवांस रिड्रेसल होना चाहिए, आपका कंसर्न है ना, आप लॉस की बात करिए, आपको फार्म रिफॉर्म्स पे इशू है, आप उसकी बात करिए, पॉलिटिकल स्टेटमेंट के लिए नहीं। आपसे एक व्यू अभी बताया है संजय हेगड़े जी ने, आप उस पर रिस्पॉन्स करिए। आप जो स्पेसिफिक पॉइंट है, ग्रीवांस रिड्रेसल होना चाहिए, आपका कंसर्न है, वो सुप्रीम कोर्ट बोलती है हम एड्रेस करने की कोशिश करेंगे थ्रू दिस मेडिएशन पैनल। नाउ दिस मेडिएशन पैनल में आपके जो ये जो मेंबर्स हैं वो आप अप्रूव नहीं करते, आपको लगता है ये सरकार के लोग हैं। आप अगर चाहते हैं सोल्यूशन हो तो वापस जाकर सुप्रीम कोर्ट को बता दीजिए कि ये जो मेंबर्स हैं हम उनसे अप्रूव नहीं करते, आप फिर से बनाइए ये कमेटी, सोल्यूशन बताइए।
किसानों के पास अभी बिल की कॉपी पहुंची है, इस पर लगातार चर्चा चल रही है, जल्द ही इसके बारे में किसान समिति सब इकट्ठा कुछ ना कुछ बताएंगे, लेकिन ये सच है कि इस कमेटी पे हमको विश्वास नहीं है, और माननीय सुप्रीम कोर्ट का हम सम्मान करते हैं, उन पर पूरा विश्वास है। जब हमारी सरकार से सीधी वार्तालाप चल रही है, अभी कल हमारी वार्ता भी है, हमको लगता है उसमें कोई ना कोई अच्छा हल निकलेगा। हम लोग पॉजिटिव सोच के आदमी हैं, हम तो जब खेतों में बीज बोते हैं तब भी हमको पता होता है कि अच्छी फसल होगी, भले ही उसको जानवर चर जाए, भले ही ओला पड़ जाए, भले ही बारिश हो जाए, लेकिन हम हमेशा पॉजिटिव सोच के साथ रहते हैं। हमको पता है कि कल सरकार हमारी कुछ ना कुछ बात मानेगी, और हो सकता है कल बिल वापसी भी हो जाए, तो हम लोग तो पॉजिटिव से
लेकिन के साथ जब बात बिल वापसी टेबल पर डिस्कशन पे है ही नहीं, जो रोल बैक का क्वेश्चन नहीं हो रहा है, अब तो ये हो रहा है कि आप लोगों का जो डिमांड है वो अनरीजनेबल लग रहा है, आप बातचीत करने के लिए भी तैयार नहीं हो रहे।
नहीं, अनरीजनेबल अगर आपको लग रहा है तो सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने इस पर रोक क्यों लगाई है, और ये लोग बदलाव क्यों करना चाहते थे? अगर बिल इतने ही अच्छे हैं तो सरकार इस बात पर क्यों तैयार है कि हम बदलाव करना चाहते हैं? अगर बदलाव करने को तैयार है तो वापस लेने में क्या दिक्कत है? अगर ये हमारा ये स्वेटर है ये फट जाए तो इसमें हम टुक्की लगवाएंगे कि नया स्वेटर खरीद लाएंगे? अरे जब उसमें कम से कम 75-80% ये बदलाव करने को तैयार है तो नया कानून बनाने में क्या दिक्कत आ रही है?
Maria, I mean, I think I agree with Mr. Hegde. He's very clear on that, that if these farmer unions approach the Supreme Court and they say, well, we have a problem with the members there, the Supreme Court will certainly listen to what they have to say, because ultimately it's a due process, it's a give and take. And we have no reservation, because I think there was something mentioned in the court that we are not going to be driven by A or B or C on who are the members. But then if there is a feeling that they would not be able to negotiate with them, some of them are Congress, some of them are whatever they are, they have a view. Every human being has a view. You heard the BJP, the Congress spokesman say that, you know, they could change the view. They could change their views from time to time. Well, that could happen for these members also.
Okay, let me bring Siraj Hussain now. He's the former Agriculture Secretary. Siraj Hussain, the Supreme Court hasn't stayed the laws but has put the implementation on hold. The protesting farmers have rejected this committee. Then what next?
I do not really know what next. But I think the committee will consider the farmers' demands in any case, even if they do not join the discussions. And I'm sure the committee members who have deep insight into these matters will consider the demand and then make their suggestions to the Supreme Court.
And Mr. Hussain, what will you tell the Congress party, which has been raising questions, and also some members of the farmer union who have been talking about the nature of this committee, that those who are on this committee are all pro-government?
Actually, that was a bit of surprise for me also. I work with Dr. Gulati and he is a very well-known economist. But then there are two experts from IFPRI alone, which was a bit of a surprise. And there is no nominee who had any views which were different from the government. So I would have preferred to see people who have not expressed their views on this subject, eminent economists, you know, possibly ex-chairman of Niti Aayog or some think tank. That would have made it more credible.
Okay, so you are essentially saying, as has been the view of Sanjay Hegde as well, that the mediators must be acceptable to all parties and appointed perhaps in consultation with them. Shama, come in on this.
Yeah, so what he says, the views have been changed. Of course, I was talking about Mr. Modi. His views have been changed, number one. Number two, which important thing is, when I'm hearing the person, the farmer, the one who's representing the farmers, he said that humko vishwas nahi hai, and he's right, because the government has said and filed a petition in court saying that we had discussions and consultations with various group before the ordinance, promulgation of the ordinance in June 2020. But do an RTI reply, the government of India says they have no record of such discussions or any of this with any group. So the government of India has lied to the Supreme Court. Mr. Modi has lied to the Supreme Court. This is what we see. So where are we heading when the government of India is lying?
Go to Siraj Hussain and Sanjay Hegde.
I just want to finish my point, yes. Maria. I have not been given time. Can I just finish my point, please? It's a request. So, number one, that point. And the other thing is, what we see right now is, it is the government of India's panel couldn't finish this discussion. It is the government of India's job. It is not the job of the judiciary. At the end, judiciary is supposed to say if it is illegal or legal, if it is constitutional or unconstitutional.
Maria, you can't allow when the law has been
stayed, the Supreme Court has not given a reason for it. That is an important point.
Yes.
So what we need
we'll
to know
talk about that with Sanjay Hegde.
Tom Barakan,
quick response.
Why is the
Supreme Court?
Yes, Tom Barakan, respond, and then I'll bring in the two experts.
See, the point is, there are meetings that happen sometimes, it's not minuted. to call the Prime Minister a liar is unfortunate.
I am calling
the
him
Congress
a liar.
Spokesman must watch her words and must apologize. The Prime Minister had discussions at various levels.
Okay, I'm
not
going,
only
yes,
in the House.
I'm going to bring in the two experts, Hansraj Hussain and Sanjay Hegde, now on the screen, please. Sanjay Hegde, there is evident distrust
you need to show
between the farmers and the government now.
Must apologize.
Please, now, Sanjay Hegde and Siraj Hussain only now. Siraj Hussain, there is evident distrust between the farmers and the government, and now this constitution of the committee being rejected and, in fact, questioned as well. How do you bridge this gap? And that is the only way the protests will end.
I think the government has today indicated its willingness to continue the deliberations, and I'm quite hopeful that 9th round of discussions will also continue. You see, both the government and the farmers' unions realize that Supreme Court does not have a major role to play in this. And ultimately, it has to be negotiated between the government and the unions. So, having said this, I am quite hopeful that government will find a solution. And many experts have suggested that government should put forward a point of view in which the government may suggest to the farmers that it will bring an amendment which will leave it to the state governments to either adopt these laws or not to adopt these laws.
But leaving that to the state governments, don't you think it will open the Pandora's box? There'll be several states who will be opposing it for political reasons also, sir.
No, Maria, that is the thing. You see, from 2003, when the Vajpayee government prepared the model law and circulated it to the states, it was always thought that it is in the state jurisdiction to enact on these subjects. It is only recently, very, very, very recently, that the center has come to a conclusion that using the trade in the constitution, it has the powers to enact laws on these subjects. So I think there is no harm if it is left to the states, and let some states which are presently ruled by the BJP show that it is good for farmers, it is good for consumers, the number of middlemen has gone down, there is no hoarding, and these laws are proving to be beneficial for everyone in the supply chain. So it is not such a bad thing. You see, at the core of it, even though Supreme Court is yet to consider this matter, but the core of the matter is that agriculture is a state subject.
Yes. Sanjay Hegde, what really happens after this committee submits a report within 2 months from the date of its first sitting, that is 10 days from now? Why should farmers who are demanding a respectful hearing now go and appear before this committee? Because after all, this is a mediation panel. They seem to be talking to the government as well. Where is the accountability here? I'm trying to understand what is the purpose of this mediation panel if from the word go they have been rejected.
This is not a mediation panel. The order doesn't describe them as a mediation panel. The order only describes them as a committee to hear the grievances of the farmers and then make recommendations. What will happen with those recommendations, the court has not yet spelled out. The court may issue directions based on those recommendations, or the court may then convey it to the government and ask for its response. So right now, the exercise as far as the court was concerned was to let everybody go back to the old status quo and have some breathing space and then move forward whichever way. So the court tried a limited maneuver to stabilize the situation. Nothing more than that ought to be read in. In theory, of course, there were lots of theoretical lines which appear to have been breached. But there is something which is called the problem-solving jurisdiction. I keep reminding people that the whole of North India was burning when the government of the day brought in Mandal. It was a court stay which enabled the country to get back to normalcy. 2 years later, the court upheld Mandal with certain riders. The country accepted it. Sometimes all that you need is some institution saying, chill, step back, take a deep breath.
And that's what the Supreme Court did.
That is what I think it did.
So it should be seen from that prism that it was well intentioned.
It definitely was well intentioned. But there is no doubt a lot of mistrust, and there has been a lot of miscommunication on all sides.
And how do you ensure that that trust deficit is reduced?
That requires great statesmanship.
Sir Rajasen, I'll give you the final words.
Can I come in to tell one point?
Sir Rajasen, I'll give you the final words.
Yes, I think the Supreme Court has provided a window of opportunity to the government to take a deep breath and reconsider its options and then put up a new proposal, a fresh proposal to the farmers, as I mentioned, which could give the states the powers to implement the act either right now or later.
Okay, Sir Raju Sen, Sanjay Hegde, always a pleasure to have you on my shows. Tom Vadakkan, Shama Mohammed, thank you so much for joining us. And Mr. Chaudhary Malik, who is the Kisan Union President as well. That's all from me. Something we'll continue to debate because there's no end in sight as far as these protests are concerned. Thanks so much.